Promo Cat here. The next episode of the Friday Zone is going to be a lot of fun. I'm not kidding.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Holy cow.
Holy cow.
That girl's got a unibrow.
Felix, do you know why kids wear glasses?
No. Why? Why do they wear glasses?
What is this?
This is a green screen, and they usually use it in movies.
So keep an eye out for the next episode of the Friday Zone. Right meow.
Production support for the Friday Zone is provided by
the WTIU Children's Programming Endowment, ensuring quality children's programming for future generations of Hoosiers. Learn more at indianapublicmedia.org/kidsfund.
The IU School of Education, dedicated to improving, teaching, and learning in a diverse and rapidly changing world. More at education.indiana.edu.
WFYI Public Media, inspiring Indiana with high-quality educational content since 1970. By sharing stories and connecting people, WFYI inspires the best in our community. And these Indiana Public Television stations. Thank you.
Ha ha ha.
What's this? A sack of gold?
That's right, I'm Robin Hood. I rob from the rich and give to the poor.
Wow, I'm rich!
Nah.
Friday. The week is done and it's time for fun. There's room for everyone.
In the Fridays, there's
so much to see. Who will we meet? It all happens magically.
Welcome to the Friday Zone, everyone. I'm Cassia.
And I'm Ethan. It's dress up today. It's dress up day today on the Friday Zone, Cassia.
Yeah. What are you supposed to be dressed up as?
Well, I couldn't decide, so I'm like a pirate who flies planes, who's also a police officer and also kind of Hawaiian, so.
Right. Well, while you try to sort yourself out, let's check out a song
on the Friday Zone playlist.
Well, maybe you can be like,
you've got a brow, 'cause we think that's hot. We know you've gotta keep it connected and fight the urge to shave that spot. Holy cow. Can't keep our eyes off of you. We don't know if that's weird. We hope that you will let it grow till it becomes an eyebrow beard. Holy cow.
Holy cow.
That girl's got a unibrow.
Holy cow, holy cow.
Hi, Lexi.
Hi, Felix.
Hi, Felix.
So guess what? Guess what?
What? What?
My friend came into class the other day, and he was wearing glasses.
Felix, do you know why kids wear glasses?
No. Why? Why do they wear glasses?
Well, some kids have different shaped eyeballs.
Really?
Yes, they're not all perfectly round, which they're supposed to be round.
Oh.
But some kids have shorter eyeballs.
Uh-huh.
And some kids have longer eyeballs.
Oh, wow. But why do they need glasses? Do glasses change your eyeball?
Well, not actually, Felix. Glasses change how the light comes into your eye.
Oh.
Because when you see a picture, it's actually light rays.
See, right here.
Yeah, I don't get it.
Get
it.
1 second. Alrighty.
Okay.
So when light comes into your eye, it hits the perfect spot at the back of your eye for a perfect picture. But when kids have different shaped eyeballs, the light doesn't hit that perfect spot anymore. It either is too short or too long, so their picture's blurry.
Oh, I see. So with glasses, the picture isn't blurry anymore.
Exactly. You have a clear, perfect picture.
Oh, that sounds great. Yeah. Oh, thank you guys so much about teaching me about glasses.
You're welcome, Felix.
Well, it's joke time with Davey.
Joke time with Jack.
Joke time with Davey and
Jack. I mean Jack. Say, Dad, let's get a skeleton in the band.
Well, that sounds like a great idea, son, but what would he play?
A trombone, of course.
Here to show us how to make a bunny mask out of a paper plate. We're going to need white construction paper, a pink marker, gray pipe cleaners, a jumbo popsicle stick, scissors, glue, and of course, a paper plate. First, cut out the inside of the paper plate. Cut out bunny ears from the white construction paper. Now you can use your pink marker to color in the inside of the ears. Glue your finished bunny ears onto your plate. Add pipe cleaners and curl the ends to make them look like whiskers. Finally, attach your popsicle stick to the bottom of your mask and voila! You have a photo booth worthy bunny mask.
In the Friday Zone.
Hey guys, it's Olivia and we're at the IU Science Fest. We're here at the media school to check out what they've got. Let's go!
Guys, we're here with Abigail and she's wearing the virtual reality headset right now. What are you seeing?
I'm seeing this ginormous pumpkin and a bunch of leaves.
And so what are you doing right now with the virtual headset?
Carving the pumpkin.
So Ava, when you look around, what do you see?
Dead trees and floating eyes.
Where's the spider? It's a... I see a giant spider web and a pumpkin right there.
Hey guys, we're here with Jack. I have a question. What is this?
This is a green screen, and they usually use it in movies. Like, if they can't go on location, they'll put a green screen behind it. Basically, the computer tones out every green object, and every green object becomes whatever the computer wants it to be. But it can't just always be green. It could be red, it could be white, it could be even blue. And they use it in movies so that they have, like, a background, like in, like, action movies. They usually have it.
I had a lot of fun here, guys, learning about virtual reality technology and green screens. I'll see you guys next time.
In the Friday Zone.
Let's go to the ultimate costume party. It's at Indie PopCon
on this Friday Zone field trip.
Hey, I'm here at PopCon, and we're here to check out a kids' cosplay competition. And we're gonna learn what it takes to make a good, detailed cosplay from your favorite TV show, movie, video game, comic book, anything. Let's go check it out.
Hey, I'm here with Isaac. Isaac, are you excited for PopCon? Oh, he's flying away. Oh, he's got big muscles. Hey, I'm here with Andrew, and he's got a really cool suit of armor. Andrew, what character are you?
My character's from Fallout 4, and we made it ourselves. We don't really know what power armor it is. We just made up our own. It's either really bad or really good. We don't know.
That's cool. You made your own, like, custom armor from Fallout 4, the video game?
First time I used it, it was only the head and then the chest and back. There was nothing else. And then for Comic-Con, we put on gloves. And then now we came here with everything on again. We didn't know if it was gonna fit though, because my head keeps growing, it's insanely big.
Yeah. Oh yeah, lined up. Oh, I can, there we go.
Hey, I'm here with Madison. And Madison, could you tell me what your costume is?
I am Azura from Fire Emblem Fates.
Oh, very cool, is that a game? And
Yeah, it's a game.
Oh, what do you do in the game?
It's basically a strategy RPG where you have to make strategies to move characters and make them fight against the enemy.
That's really cool. How did you make your costume?
Well, we looked on the internet and we tried to find it, but they didn't come in my size, so we literally had to go from scratch. So we used a bunch of older pieces of material and just made it.
That's impressive.
We bought some of it and we made this out of plastic and wood.
I could not tell. That you make it look so fancy. Did your family help you make that?
Yes, my grandma. Oh,
grandmas make the best costumes. I'm here with Abby, and Abby is a weeping angel from what show is this?
Doctor Who.
Doctor Who. Oh, why did you pick this costume in particular?
Because it's cool.
Because it's cool. It is cool. It is very cool. How did you make the costume? It looks very complicated.
The wings are made out of wire and duct tape around them with stuffing and spray paint on them. And this, it's made out of a bed sheet. One of our neighbors made it.
And you got
she
like
had
some
it.
Kind of paint? Or
it's a spray paint. It's a stone-like spray paint.
Yeah, you look like a statue. That's awesome. And I see you painted your face also. That's really cool. And your hair also?
It's a wig.
It's a wig.
Spray paint.
A spray painted wig. That's awesome. How long did it take to put this together?
How long did it take? 20 hours?
It took a couple days.
a couple days.
I'm here with Joseph, and you went as Star-Lord from Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yes. My Walkman is a modified cassette player we got off eBay with the right cassette tape, and yes, it works. This t-shirt was custom printed, and the patches on my backpack were hand-sewn.
There's a lot of heart in this costume.
Yes, there is. There is a lot of work, time, and a lot of research went into it.
That's what it takes. That's what it takes to do a good cosplay.
People have tried to do this backpack, but most of them are the wrong color or don't have the right patches. We had to research and identify every last stitch on the patch to make sure it was accurate.
You did a great job. Wow, I had a lot of fun at this cosplay competition. These kids drew inspiration from their favorite video games, TV shows, movies, comic books. There's all kinds of characters, and they put so much detail into their costumes just to honor the thing that they love.
And now, a story from a winner of the WTIU Kids Writers Contest.
Today when I was swimming at the pool with my friends Andrea and Zoe, a whirlpool surrounded my feet. Andrea and Zoe started going into a huge conversation about ocean animals and acted like I didn't exist. I said, "Hello," repeatedly, louder each time, but they didn't even bat an eyelash. They started drifting away, but I swam toward them. I was much quicker than before. Why? I looked down, instead of feet at the end of my legs, two bright red fins. My white legs had a dark blue stripe running down either side. Was I a mermaid? Something told me to swim over to the drain. I was thinking about fish, tiny ones. Suddenly, I was moving quickly. I was in the drain. I raised my hand to slow my transportation through the pipes. Wait a minute, I was a fish. I was a shapeshifter. Immediately, I burst out of the pipe. I was in open water, the ocean. Somehow I knew it was the Atlantic Ocean, but I was back in mermaid form. I saw a sand-golden palace rise up out of the ocean floor, and many mermaids and mermen and mergirls and merboys playing, talking, eating, shopping, playing with their catfish, or taming their dogfish. Right next to me, some purple coral had black octopuses ink on it. I read, "Welcome to Atlantis." I wanted to explore, but I thought my friends would probably wonder where I was, so I decided to go back. I turned around to leave, but behind me was nothing but a huge black trench. Above me was a small boat. Fish form, I thought, and soon I was back at the pool. I didn't have fins or weird markings on my legs. Andrea and Zoe hadn't moved from their spot. We were all laughing at the joke Andrea made before I got fins. I wanted to tell my friends about what happened, but I was not exactly sure what happened myself. But I knew this was only the beginning of my adventures with fins for feet.
How would you like to see something you wrote on the Friday Zone? It's easy. Just enter the WTIU Kids Writers Contest. Ask your teacher how to enter, or request an entry form from WTIU@indiana.edu.
Zarg, I've given a lot of thought to your comfort and making it easy for you to learn how to read.
Reading is hard for Zarg.
And I think I know why.
Maybe Zarg is dumb.
No! You most certainly are not. You just see the world differently, and there is nothing wrong with that. In fact, I think you may be dyslexic.
Lysdexic? What is lysdexic?
People with dyslexia have trouble connecting the letters they see with the sounds those letters and combinations of letters make.
Like my D's and B's.
Yes, Zarg, like your D's and B's. Zarg, may I read something to you?
Zarg trusts Peggy.
This is a poem by Edgar Albert Guest entitled, It Couldn't Be Done. Somebody said that it couldn't be done, but he with a chuckle replied that maybe it couldn't, but he would be one who wouldn't say so till he'd tried. So he buckled right in with a trace of a grin on his face. If he worried he'd hit it, he'd started to sing as he tackled the thing that couldn't be done, and he did it. What do you say, Zarg? Are you willing to try the thing that couldn't be done?
Zarg will try.
Good, because I have something that might help you.
What is it?
Well, instead of symbols on a page that represents letters, I have read that three-dimensional shapes may make it easier for you to learn your letters. Here, Zarg. Here's a D.
Yes, it is a D.
Yes, Zarg, that's it.
Peggy, you are Zarg's best friend.
Someone just stole my wallet.
Oh no, Sammy, what did they look like?
Bea, I don't know. It happened so fast.
This is tricky, but I think I know what to do. We'll sketch them.
But Bea, I'm terrible at drawing.
You don't have to draw, Sammy. Along with being a master forensic scientist, I am also a certified police sketch artist. The police call me when they need a sketch of a criminal.
Okay, I think I'm ready.
Don't worry, Sammy, we'll catch them. First, did you notice any really distinguishable features? Was there anything about them that stood out to you?
Yes, he was a man. He had really dark, curly hair. He had green eyes, he had a really sharp chin, a long nose, like really long nose, a really small mouth, and a mustache, and a scar along his right eye.
Okay, I think I got it. Does this look like the man?
Yes, that's him. I'm gonna go show this to people on the street and see if anyone has seen him.
Thanks to you all for helping us solve the case. See you next time.
Welcome to Animal Yoga. My name is Priscilla, and I'm here to practice yoga together with you. Let's take a deep belly breath in and check how are we feeling in this very moment. Now bring our hands in front of our hearts. Namaste. Ready to begin? Today we are gonna be like dogs. So we are gonna go on our hands and knees, our hands under our shoulders and our knees under our hips. And we're gonna tuck our toes under. And we're gonna bring our hips really high. Woo! And we're gonna walk our dogs. Our hands stay on where they are, but we can pedal our feet. And then I'm gonna raise one leg up and we can shake our tail. And now bring it down and then bring the other one up and shake your tail. All right, so now we're gonna do one more time. Bring the other leg up and really, really high. And we're gonna open and look under. Can you look under your armpit? And you go woof, 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 woof. Can you guys bark? Very good. And now let's try the other side. Bring the other leg up and look under your armpit. Woof, 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 woof. Now we're gonna jump forward. And then. Thank you for joining me. May all be peaceful. May all be well. And may all be happy. Namaste.
Hey, Cassia, I brought all of my costume stuff, and I think it'd be cool if we made a costume.
Ooh, let's make a costume. Okay, and thank you guys for joining us on the Friday Zone.
Remember to visit our website, FridayZone.org, to watch past episodes, play games, see behind-the-scenes photos.
And remember to live, learn, and play
the Friday Zone way.
Okay.
Cool, all right.
Okay. That works.
Cool, I'm gonna do the Hawaiian thing again, I guess.
Oh, I like, is this like a little?
Oh, that's kind of cute. It's like a
that's
nice little
cute.
Vest. It's a good thing.
Yeah.
Fun, so this is an arm piece, I'm pretty sure.
An arm piece. You look like a.
What's up?
You look like you're gonna go to a pool party.
That was the plan with this one. That was like the inspiration, for sure. Ooh, we could both have a glove on.
Production support for the Friday Zone is provided by
the WTIU Children's Programming Endowment, ensuring quality children's programming for future generations of Hoosiers. Learn more at indianapublicmedia.org/kidsfund.
The IU School of Education, dedicated to improving, teaching, and learning in a diverse and rapidly changing world. More at education.indiana.edu.
WFYI Public Media, inspiring Indiana with high-quality educational content since 1970. By sharing stories and connecting people, WFYI inspires the best in our community. And these Indiana Public Television stations. Thank you.
We're not kidding around. There's a whole litter of more content on our website, FridayZone.org. There you can catch up on past episodes and dig into our archived segments. There's info for parents, teachers, and even a link to contact our show. It's more fun than a ball of yarn.